my favorite examples of momentum in a bullish range is gold. Throughout 2009, 2010, this is one of the biggest rallies in the history of the gold market. It's very clear, higher highs, higher lows for years above an upward sloping 200-day moving average. When it comes to just price, this is the definition of an uptrend. So now we want to focus our attention on momentum, this 14-day relative strength index. Notice how in the correction in early 2009, the correction in late 09, early 2010, and once again the correction in the summer of 2010, momentum never reached oversold conditions. What that's doing is that it's reiterating that we are in an uptrend, but in rallies we are getting overbought. It's when the market starts to get oversold and fails to get overbought that we start seeing some issues, and that's exactly what happened before gold peaked. Another great example is Tesla. Tesla Motors throughout 2012 and early 2013 was in a sideways range. Okay? The weight of the evidence here suggested that prices were not in an uptrend. In fact, prices were trading near that flat 200-day moving average, that situation that creates headaches, that situation that we want to stay away from. So we turn to see what momentum is doing, see if it's confirming that. And what is momentum telling us? Well, during this entire sideways range, momentum was getting overbought, but it was not getting oversold. So while price itself was not in an uptrend, momentum was already telling us that we should be focused on something because there's underlying strength in this market. So I think Tesla Motors is a great example of price telling us one thing and then momentum giving us a heads up that that might be changing. And then sure enough, once we got the breakout above that base throughout 2012, we had one of the most epic rallies in stock market history. And if you were looking at momentum, you would have gotten a heads up that the resolution out of this base was most likely going to be higher.